Uchiha grew closer to the realm of the gods. Until an ancient goddess, Kaguya Atsutsuki, surpassed him. The being who had controlled all of Shinobi history disappeared, leaving only Naruto and Sasuke behind. The time had come for them to settle everything.
They had both led each other to growth. They had both forced each other to walk down separate paths. They had walked together, create joy, create sadness, create panic, and create bonds. But the dreams they dreamed of began to change, and they split apart into a ninja who focused on his allies and a ninja who focused on revolution. Which path would history choose? Now, everything would be decided. This would be the final battle between Naruto and Sasuke. And I am not going to be commentating at all during it. Once more, people, let us get this show on the road one last time with your host, Jungoguy. For the sake of the future!
Now, I'm returning to the other side, too. But before I leave, I want to ask you something. Naruto and Sasuke. After fighting my mother, Kaguya, did your answers change?
Mine hasn't. For a very long time, my wish has always been to protect my friends.
I see.
Ah, that reminds me. What happened to all the people who got hypnotized by the infinite Tsukuyomi? I want to hurry up and save them all!
Undoing the jutsu is a simple thing. With your tailed beast chakra, Naruto, and your Rinnegan, Sasuke, you simply need to make the Ko seal.
Oh, that's surprisingly easy! Sasuke!
Yeah.
What about you? The answer you gave back then.
I don't mind if you free them. But only after I execute the 5 Kage while they're still hypnotized.
What? Sasuke, are you still planning on getting revenge?
Sasuke, what do you want? What do you desire from the end of this battle? I want to know the honest truth.
The previous Kage are the ones who created this situation. I'm going to become the Hokage and change the village.
And the Hokage you become, what exactly will that be?
If you really want to know, I'll tell you. It's true that up until now, destruction and revenge were my only goals. But that's changed. I'm going to destroy and then rebuild. I'm going to create a village, a world without darkness. In other words, what I wish for is... revolution.
Planetary devastation!
No!
Kurama!
Naruto!
I'm going to save you! Just hold on for a second!
Now no one is left to stand in my way. Besides you, Naruto.
I suppose it really was too good to be true. Indra and Asura will always follow the same paths.
No. The brothers' battle is going to end here.
You know where we need to go, right?
I know there's nothing I can do. Despite how much I care about him, how much I love him, I can't follow him. I can't die with him. Even now, all I can do is stamp my feet and cry. I'm so pathetic. Sasuke! If you have even the tiniest spot in your heart for me, then please, don't go off somewhere again!
You really are annoying.
Didn't have to use genjutsu on her as well!
Sakura... just wanted to save you. You tried to kill her once. And she still just keeps shedding tears for you. Because loving you is torturing her.
That may just be a chain from our failed past.
Sasuke.
I promised Sakura a long time ago that I'd bring you back to the village. Sensei! You know what my ninja way is, right? Here I go!
Yeah, I'm counting on you.
You don't have any parents or siblings. How could you understand? You've been alone from the very beginning. What could you possibly understand about me, huh?
I've already severed my bond with you. I told you already, you have no siblings or parents you couldn't possibly understand.
This is none of your business!
I knew you'd be here. This sure brings back memories, Sasuke.
Just like before, you're going to lose here.
I won't let you land any of the punches you did last time. And I won't hand the title of Hokage to you either. You don't understand what it means to be the Hokage.
I told you, what I desire is revolution. The Hokage I speak of is nothing like yours. Itachi Uchiha. My brother was born in the shadows and protected the village from the shadows. You understand how he lived, right? That's the Hokage I want to become. Moving in the darkness, caring about the village, accepting all the hatred and working for peace. To that end, it doesn't matter how much I have to dirty my hands. I'll accept all the hatred that's born from that. I don't have a father, a mother, or a brother. I'm all alone. I can carry the hatred all by myself. Yes, the Hokage I want to be will burn down the darkness of all five Kage with his own flames, then feast on the ashes to survive.
You're completely misunderstanding how Itachi lived! There are some things you can't do alone. Like in the battle with Kaguya!
Things won't always go well. Like these two statues. And us. Like us brothers. In the end, what this world needs is revolution. I'll take care of all the darkness from the past and restart things with a pure, unwritten future.
Are you saying you're going to cut off all your memories of Team 7?
Yes. I'm going to cut off my past.
I won't let you do that! I learned everything from people of the past! It's because I had my friends that I was able to keep moving forward! They're what created the me that's here now! I'm never gonna let you cut that away!
Then, you must know what you need to do. Naruto!
Sasuke!
Is meaningless to me.
Right there!
What about Sakura? She never stopped!
Memories and love are only chains. Idealistic things that have no place in my revolution.
No place? Enough of that crap, Sasuke!
You're going to die here, Naruto! Burn away!
Will come true.
How many times do I have to tell you? You can't beat me!
You're just as stubborn as ever.
That's my ninja way! You should know that by now!
Then I'll just cut that down along with you. You don't have what it takes to stop me. Damn it. Doesn't matter how much you try and fight.
I promised Sakura that I'd bring you back. I'm going to keep my promise this time!
Right there!
Let's go!
To do is erase you, and then no one will be able to stand in the way of my revolution! Everything!
No, you won't. Kurama and I are gonna stop you! History, and all of our connections with our allies, and everyone else, including...
Now I'm all alone.
What's wrong? Don't tell me you've given up already. Is it really that easy for you two to sever your connection? It isn't, is it?
Just like Obito and me, your connection with Sasuke can't be severed that easily.
Remember, you didn't just reconnect Kakashi and me. My heart was so hardened, yet you. And it wasn't just me. You opened up a lot of other people's hearts as well. enemies. People surrounded by hatred. People who rejected the other villages. People who were hurting inside. Even the tailed beasts. You were even capable of solving the problems of the world itself. Now, there's only one person left. It should be easy for you to save a stubborn friend. Right?
Yeah, you'll be fine. Remember that you bear the encouragement of all those people on your shoulders. The connections you've made with your teachers and your peers. The hopes of your friends. If you don't have enough power, then just borrow it from their hands. Because, Naruto, that's all the power that you created.
Your heart isn't dead yet.
If he's submerging himself in darkness, then just use your hands to pull him back up.
And if he tries to shake you off, then scream to wake him up.
There's no such thing as a feeling that cannot be conveyed.
Everyone believes in you, Naruto.
You make the impossible possible.
Naruto, that's why.
You need to get back up already!
Don't be afraid to look stupid as you struggle.
That is the Naruto we all know!
You can do it, Naruto!
Connections don't disappear.
You need to harden your fist and stand up again!
Keep that fire in your eyes!
Let out a roar!
Come on! Sasuke's waiting for you!
Go to him, Naruto! This is all for your sake!
For the sake of the future! For the sake of your friend!
Forward!
Go, Naruto!
Just yet, Sasuke!
Why? Over and over. Why do you keep doing this? What's wrong with you? Just what are you?
Your friend. I told you I can't leave you alone, remember?
You're still saying that? After all this? I told you already. I have no intention of going back.
And I told you that I have no intention of giving up. It doesn't matter what you say to me. I'll never change my mind. I'm just gonna keep reaching out my hand to you. Until the very end. Until I reach you.
My will won't change either. I'm going to cut you down in order to end the path I've walked so far.
I won't give up on you in order to keep my path connected.
Neither of us has much power left. Yes, this is the true end.
cut you down!
That just shut up already!
Connections are what make this world such a pain. The stronger the connection, the more it tortures me. Naruto, my connection to you is the most irritating one of all. Why didn't you just cut me off when I went into the darkness?
How could I? You were like a brother to me. So my body and my heart just act on their own. Just kept thinking, hoping that you wouldn't have to be all alone.
You.
Do you remember? The entire village used to hate me, and I hated them right back. One bad move, and I could have been exactly like you. And I was always alone. I felt better knowing there was someone like me out there. I was happy. I wanted to be your friend, be around you sooner. But I didn't. I was also jealous of you. You were good at everything. So I decided you'd be my rival. You were my goal. You always have been. I had nothing. But I built bonds. And then in our missions as Team 7, I kept chasing after you. I wanted to be like you. So, Sasuke, I've never actually said it before, but I'm happy. Happy I knew you.
Naruto, no matter what you say now, I'm not changing. I'm still going to destroy each and every person in the Leaf. Including you. Either defeat me and become the hero who saved the village, or fall to me and just be known as a pitiful loser. Those are your only choices.
I'm not gonna be a loser, or the hero who defeated you. I won't be either.
Why? What do you want?
Right here!
I'm going to beat you here, just like I did before. You're going to lose. Without ever messing up to me!
You know that I'm different from how I was back then, don't you? I won't lose anymore!
No. You haven't changed. That's what's irritating me so much.
What?
You've always been the same. That attitude of yours has never changed. Damn it!
Right here!
Give up! act all cool every day. You really piss me off.
Huh? You're the one to talk. You're the one who's always doing stupid stuff. Just looking at you pisses me off.
You can't do that, can you? I'm awesome.
How petty can you be? You should be ashamed of yourself.
Huh. I'm not ashamed at all. You're the one who's always sulking all the time. Just looking at you pisses me off.
Huh?
You should play more with the rest of us. If you just played with us a little more... Whoa, wait, what am I saying? Stupid, stupid, stupid!
Did you just confuse yourself? You really make no sense.
Yeah. Now do you finally get it? See? If you move, the wound will open.
Why are you so obsessed with standing in my way? I acquired this strength so I could cut everything off and enter the darkness. Naturally, everyone tried to break their bonds with me at least once. But you... you never did. Why are you so determined to stay involved with me?
Huh. How many times do I have to tell you? Don't you get it by now?
Just answer me!
Because we're friends.
Just what is a friend to you?
You can't explain something like that with words. But whenever I see you trying to carry everything on your shoulders like that, it hurts. It hurts so bad that I just can't ignore you.
Naruto. I know that you've always been alone. Just like me. You felt alienated in the village. But unlike me, you did stupid things to try and get people's attention. Back then, I thought you were an idiot, a weakling. But deep down inside, I was interested in you too. Then we both grew and ended up on the same team. I did missions together with you, while you kept going on and on about how you wanted to become the Hokage. And as I felt us growing stronger together, I decided that I wanted to fight you someday. Then, I started to see Team 7 as my own family. That's why, whenever I saw you in pain, yes, I also hurt. When I understood your pain, that's when I first thought of you as a friend. But in return, as I saw you grow exponentially strong, I just couldn't ignore you. You had a strength that I lacked. You were always walking in front of me, just like my brother did. And the same is true today. You.
Guess it's too soon for you to move. Just when I thought I could punch you to wake you up. Huh? What?
You still want to keep fighting?
Of course, I'll fight you as many times as...
I accept it.
Huh?
I lost.
You idiot! This isn't about winning or losing! My friend was sulking, so I just thought I'd punch him to wake him up, that's all!
Hey, Naruto. I accept you. If I die here, the chain of war that's been continuing since the time of the Sage of the Six Paths will come to an end. This is another type of revolution. I'll decide this issue myself, once and for all.
How can you decide anything by dying? You might as well live on and help me instead, if you're just gonna do that! What I want to do is cooperate with all the shinobi! Including you, of course.
Who says everyone else will agree to that?
Oh, come on! Go on! Spout some more crap like that! I'll punch you again!
There's no telling when I may stand up to defy you again in the future.
You won't do this kind of thing anymore!
How can you be sure of that?
Don't make me repeat myself!
Just what are you?
We're friends!
Why are you so obsessed with me?
Because we're friends!
Why are you so determined to stay involved with me?
How many times do I have to tell you? Don't you get it by now?
Just answer me!
Come on! You're the one who still doesn't get it! Now that I think about it, I guess you always have been surprisingly dense.
I was so worried! Shut up. I was so worried about you! You guys, you idiots!
I knew they'd be here.
Kakashi-sensei.
Yeah, go to them.
I'm not gonna lose to you!
Say whatever you want, you brain-dead loser.
Enough, Naruto! Shut up already!
So, he's finally returned.
What's happening? What's going on? Oh, hell no. No, 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 no. Stop the credits. Stop the credits. It's, we are not doing that yet. I'm the host of this show, and I say we are not doing the credits until everything has been shown. Now move over.
We used to be all alone, starving for love, children who were festering with hatred. We went our separate ways and fought. But Naruto, you never cut me off. You just kept moving closer to my heart. Even though it would have made sense for you to attack me with hatred, you told me I was your friend. And no matter how much I hurt you, you accepted me as one. I was only saved thanks to you. We used to do nothing but quarrel, and now we can feel the pain of each other's hearts. And this isn't just between us. It may be something that can be said in a much larger scope.
To be honest, you should have been thrown in jail for what you did. The reason you were pardoned is because you made a great contribution to stopping the infinite Tsukuyomi. But don't forget that me becoming the sixth Hokage and Naruto's appeals were a big part of that as well. Don't do anything too crazy anymore, or else I'll have to take responsibility for it.
Thanks. I appreciate it.
Do you really have to go?
Now, I want to know how the Shinobi world, how this world looks to me.
What if I asked you if I could come along?
This is also a journey of repentance. You have nothing to do with my sins.
Nothing to do with them, huh?
See you later. Thanks. You still have that?
I'm giving it back.
How about I keep it until our next battle? But I could never do things like you could. It was never that easy for me. That emotion felt like a prayer. I'll just have to bear this until I can really do it. And the ones who have been tasked with that are us.
Naruto.
Ninja.
There is a chain that began from creation and continued through the Otsutsuki, never ceasing. People became shinobi and created clans and villages, even during peaceful interludes. The flames of war never died out, but grew ever stronger, along with hatred. And so, those two continued to face each other, fighting on and on. However, a single ninja was able to sever that chain and cultivate a new future. He created best friends, followed them, challenged them, and connected them. His will gradually came to encompass all shinobi, the world, and all its hatred, until it came to reveal a new path. Here, the handbook that encompasses everything about the way of the shinobi reaches its conclusion. Now, it's time to give that handbook a title. And so it will be named The Tale of Naruto Uzumaki.
All right, now we can cue the credits. And I'm going to use this time to go over what happened to the rest of the characters. The game didn't go over because that pisses me off. off, and I figured this is a good opportunity in case any of you guys haven't read the manga and epilogue by now. And or just waiting on the anime, because who knows when the anime is going to get up to this point. So, spoilers. Here we go. And so, everyone who had been in prison by the Infinite Tsukuyomi was set free before they could be turned into White Zetsu. As for the remaining White Zetsu in Kaguya's army, with the internal genjutsu undone, they withered away into dust, unnoticed by all save one. Captain Yamato, having been held captive for the duration of the war by the White Zetsu, and being used as a human puppet by Guruguru during his fight with Orochimaru and the Third Hokage, remember that? He was set free upon the Infinite Tsukuyomi's release and was the only one who saw Guruguru crumble away into dust. And he returned to the Hinwheat village, where he continues to serve to this day. Having seen the flaws in his way of thinking through Kamacho's failures, Orochimaru realized that trying to copy someone else entirely from Pete was stupid. He returned to working on his research, Urchin's laboratory, accompanied by Sugetsu, Saku, Karin, and Jugo. But as long as he didn't leave his lab and try and do anything evil, the Hinwheat decided to at least tolerate him. Though they did assign Captain Yamato to watch the lab in case he tried to leave. Having remembered who he was, as truly thanks to Itachi, Kabuto returned to the orphanage where he had been raised and became its new head. The Hinwheat villagers promptly let him go as long as he had agreed to quit being a ninja for the rest of his life. I'm not joking about that. I think that's the only way they would let him live. There's no way he could stay hidden forever. Especially when the orphanage was so close to the Hinwheat village. Speaking of the Hinwheat villages, the Allied Shinobi forces following the war's end were reorganized into the Shinobi Union, an alliance that any ninja village could join. Led by the Five Kage, the Union would accept missions and then choose the ninja best suited for the job from each member village so that there would be no competition. Within a few years, other villages had already begun to join the Union, and helping to eliminate competition and spreading peace across the land. As for the Five Kage who served during the war, most of them would retire over the next 10 years. The Fourth Raikage would pass on his role to his right-hand man, Daori. The Third Tsuchikage would finally retire. It's about time, too. He's super old. And pass on the title to her granddaughter, Kutsuchi. Chojuro would take over the position as the Sixth Hokage, Mizukage from Mei. Angar continues to serve as the Fifth Kazekage up into the present. The former Kage continued to meet and hold reunions frequently, usually at the Tsuchikage's residence. It's because as the Third Tsuchikage is now so old, he can't move out. Having finally been set free, after decades of imprisonment, and having learned to trust humanity, and earned their trust in return, the Tame Beast returned to the wild, never having to worry about being sealed away again. Well, not all of them left. Yuki decided to remain with Killer Bee for the time being. And yes, Bee is still alive. He managed to survive getting his Tame Beast ripped out of him by holding onto a fragment of Yuki's chakra, then he cut off his tail. And used a substitution jutsu or something. He pulled the same trick he used on when they fought Sasuke and they thought he captured him. That's how he saved his life. As for Kurama, he was more than happy to return to Naruto and rejoin his other half, though he will never openly admit it. But thanks to Naruto's intervention, Mike Guy managed to survive opening the Gate of Death and made a full recovery. Sadly, the damage done to the leg he used to deliver that badass kick to Mara was irreparable, confining him to a wheelchair for the rest of his days. He's effectively ending his ninja career. Didn't stop him from trying to keep being a ninja, though. You know my guy. As for all of Naruto's friends from the Hinleaf, I'm not spoiling it for you. Go read the last chapter in the manga. It's in full color and is online right now, or in a bookstore. I'm not spoiling that for you guys, especially not the couples thing. Like father, like son, huh? You certainly look like you got your hands full, Lord Seventh Hokage.
Where leaves fall, flames burn. The shadows of the flames illuminate the village. And again, new leaves bloom.
To all those who stuck around until the end of this journey, thank you all for coming along. Starting next week, I'm going to be posting short videos of all the cool-ass ninja techniques that we can do in this game. And so be prepared for some more ninja awesomeness for some time to come. Spoiler alert, I'm going to be doing the reverse air jutsu first. Until next time, this is Jungoguy.